Hey, so what's up, lovely artist friends?
So it's been such a while. I have been painting and sketching a bit, and I have been living a lot. So here are still some art shots from 2020 to inspire you for 2021. A whole wonderful creative year. Yeah, we have to make it so. Going to be pretty cool to have all my stuff all around. So I am at my desk right now and I can pick some paper in here. I have some stuff in here also. I think it's always so handy. I have the acrylic stamps on the IKEA thing, but for now most of my art supplies are in this little drawer furniture. I also have another box in here for pen. So before moving, I try to sort all my pens and putting them together, and also give away a few to friends that I didn't really use, but I appreciate so much, you know, even just with the rubber bands like this, to have a bit of all your pen organized, and you know a bit where you have to search for when you are searching for something special. Here I have the acrylic markers as well. It's not finished, you know. I will keep working on this. So this is a bit of the ink and painting additional stuff, and here below you have the real ink drawer, and I think at the end I will add a bit of demo label on my drawer. It can look so cute and so nice, and nice to keep things organized. Time. I shot quite a lot of things from you, always hoping to be able to finish some video bits and to be able to share them. So I am sorry if I, you know, disappointed you. And I would totally understand that would be a bit upset with me for disappearing for so long. But in my opinion, in my feeling, you were always with me and I was always with you. Thank you for that. I thought about you so many times, you know, always wanting to share, shooting things, hoping to inspire and to be there for you, but life was like a wonderful storm and I didn't always have enough energy and time to manage and to really finish the project I was engaging in.
Oh yeah, you are too cute together!
Watercolor workshop in Guanajuato, Mexico was such a wonderful experience. It was a lot of painting by myself and also with a group, of course, and the teaching, the meeting new people, discovering a new country with so many colors. I want to go back for sure. So this would deserve a whole video, oh, probably several ones. I shot a ton, so maybe one day I'll just include it like this as a glimpse in other videos, hoping to inspire you once again. Coming back from Mexico late March, such an unexpected but so hoped for surprise and event happened.
I mean, isn't it almost a movie-like story to find love during a lockdown? You are my sunshine. You are my moonlight. You are my angel. You make me feel alright. So yes, because of the quarantine, I decided to move again in order to be able to share time with this adorable guy, despite the restrictions and staying at home rules. I love you. Pressure approach for my art and craft, and living with Jeremy's little girls make me do some coloring in and scribbling and all kind of probably childlike stuff that make me a lot of good and what's really fun to do. A bit of a spring for my creativity and art, I guess. Of course, I'm always catching up with urban sketchers, meeting Everyday Matters style, with trying to recording things in my life through sketching. Sketchbooking rocks! And it's always so fun to experiment with various tools and techniques, like in here sometimes ink, or pencils, or even rainbow scratching paper. So refreshing and fun, as I told you. In May, I came back a bit more to watercolor in two really different styles. First of all, this approach that you know really much from me, you know, really loose, colorful and splattery, and painting flowers because of spring, of course. Woohoo! Let's paint some flowers to celebrate spring's color, watercolor and artistic joyfulness. I wish you a nice, lovely time for spring and see you soon. At the time, I was also attracted and drawn by a more illustration style. I was really inspired by an artist I am following on Instagram named Helen Dordick. Her bright colors, her smooth shapes and the cute characters. So I decided to try out a bit of this kind of stuff. For this drawing, I am really emulating her style, not to copy, but in order, I think, to understand a bit how she creates her art. So this is not really mine, it's not hers either, maybe it's a bit in the middle. It's my interpretation of her own little poetic world, I guess. In June, a bit of urban sketching, scribbling and, you know, enjoying a walk with the family. So great! I think it's still putting colors and shapes together to make something pretty, isn't it? And of course, never forgetting to have fun. In July, we tried some kind of sparkly drawing with the kids, and it was a whole mess and a lot of fun. So you have to kind of remove the stickers. You want to put some shiny thing in. Not so easy. And then pouring a bit of this, I'm having fun with it! Well, too much! I am shooting a Patreon to show how much living with kids is really fun and make you try so much nice of shiny creative stuff! So, I'm doing a zebra.
Koala time!
Oh, wow! Yeah, a lot of African creatures! Woo-woo-woo! Craziness! Oh, here is my piece of art for the day! I'm sure you are so looking forward to see the final piece! A cutie, shiny zebra. Yes. So here are the little works. Done. And now stay tuned for episode 2, where I am making new fun creative experiments, painting subjects from nature. We are getting us into crazy adventures, and we are moving again in a lovely farmhouse to renovate with a huge garden. You'll see me having my hair growing, painting our new house, getting a kitten for my 40th birthday, spending Christmas with the family in our new home, and more. So, see you soon. May the creative force be with you.